గుడ్ ఆఫ్టర్నూన్ వెల్కమ్ టు గుడ్ హెల్త్ పీసీఓఎస్ తో బాధపడుతున్నారా ఇది రావడానికి కారణాలు ఏంటి వీటి సింప్టమ్స్ ఏ విధంగా ఉంటాయి వీటికి ఎలాంటి జాగ్రత్తలు తీసుకోవాలి అదే విధంగా పీసీఓఎస్ కు ఎలాంటి ట్రీట్మెంట్ అందుబాటులో ఉంది వీటి గురించి తెలియజేయడానికి ఈ రోజు మనతో పాటు ఉన్నారు రెనోవా నీలిమా హాస్పిటల్స్ డాక్టర్ ఎంఎస్ పూర్ణిమ అలాగే ఎంఎస్ కన్సల్టెంట్ గైనకాలజిస్ట్ వారితో మాట్లాడి మరిన్ని విషయాలు తెలుసుకుందాం హలో మ్యామ్
హలో
ఓకే ఫస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ చెప్పండి అసలు పీసీఓఎస్ అంటే ఏంటి
అందరికి నమస్కారం ఫస్ట్ వెరీ గుడ్ ఆఫ్టర్నూన్ PCOS is also called as polycystic ovarian syndrome, or it is called PCOD, that is polycystic ovarian disease. And PCOS is a multi-system disorder. That is, it does not involve only one system. There's involvement of endocrine system, there's involvement of genetic system, metabolic system, as well as reproductive system. So all to combine, it's a multi-system disorder, and it usually affects women in the reproductive age group, that is between 18 to 44 years of age group. Now let us, in simple words, I'll explain to you why is it called as PCOS. Normally every month during your ovulation time, the ovaries will have multiple follicles, and these multiple follicles are usually in different stages of development or maturation, and only one follicle in this will release egg, and that is called as dominant follicle. And this dominant follicle usually grows and grows and grows in size, and then it gets released from the ovaries and then releases the egg on the 15th day. So this is the normal ovulation process which happens. Now let me explain what happens in PCOS. PCOS lo em aitadante, all the follicles will be normally present in PCOS. But what happens is there's not enough hormonal drive for it to reach the dominant stage. So none of the follicles become dominant follicle. When none of the follicles become dominant follicle, all of them are in immature stage. So when all of them are in immature stage, none of them get released from the ovaries and none will release the egg. So there is no ovulation which is happening in PCOS. So basically polycystic ovaries means there are multiple follicles which are present in the ovary, which are all in immature stage and which are stuck in the ovary. The most common doubts which the patients who come to me have is cyst in the ovary and polycystic ovary. So all of them get confused when I say polycystic ovary. Most of them think it's the cyst in the ovary. If you understand what I explained just now, it is not the cyst which is present in the ovary, it is the follicles which are present in the ovary, and these follicles are in immature stage, and hence there will be hormonal imbalance, and which will lead to all the symptoms of PCOS.
Okay ma'am, PCOS raavadaniki causes enti, main causes enti sir?
Okay, as I said, about 5% of our population is suffering from PCOS. That is, 1 in 5 women who come to our OPD have PCOS, but only 50% of it is diagnosed. This is because in India there is absolute lack of awareness of PCOS. So most of it is diagnosed at a later stage, and the prevalence is definitely increasing day by day. The most important cause for PCOS, one of the strongest I feel, is genetic predisposition. That is, if your mother, meer amma ki, I mean, if your older sister or if any of your aunt is suffering from PCOS, then there is high chance of you suffering PCOS later in your life too. So this is one of the important cause for PCOS. Another important cause other than the genetic predisposition is your environmental influences. That is, excessive stress, lifestyle modifications, sedentary lifestyle, and dietary changes like eating more of junk and, you know, not doing any exercise. All these things will lead to hormonal imbalance and in turn indirectly will cause PCOS. So mainly these are the causes for PCOS. And the most important thing I feel is the environmental influences, because genetic predisposition, it is, you're born with that, so you cannot make any changes with that. But lifestyle, dietary changes, stress, definitely you can make some changes, lifestyle modifications in that, and that helps a lot in reducing the severity and complications of PCOS.
ఓకే మ్యామ్, అలాగే మనము పీసీఓఎస్ ఉన్నట్లయితే బాడీలో ఎలాంటి చేంజెస్ రెగ్యులర్గా చూస్తూ ఉంటాము, సిమ్టమ్స్ ఏ విధంగా ఉంటాయి?
ఓకే, ఆల్ ద ఉమెన్ హూ కమ్ టు మీ విత్ పీసీఓఎస్ డోంట్ ప్రెజెంట్ విత్ ద సేమ్ సిమ్టమ్స్. పీసీఓఎస్ ఇస్ డిఫరెంట్ ఫార్ ఎవ్రీ ఉమెన్ ఐ సీ. సో డిఫరెంట్ ఉమెన్ ప్రెజెంట్ విత్ డిఫరెంట్ సిమ్టమ్స్ అండ్ ద మోస్ట్ కామన్ అంటే ఒక 70% ఆఫ్ ద ఉమెన్ హూ కమ్ విత్ పీసీఓఎస్ విల్ హ్యావ్ మెన్స్ట్రల్ ఇర్రెగ్యులారిటీస్, దట్ ఈస్ ఇర్రెగ్యులర్ పీరియడ్స్ అని చెప్తారు. యూజువలీ నార్మలీ పీరియడ్స్ అందరూ ఏమనుకుంటారంటే 28-30 డేస్కే రావాలి అనుకుంటారు, బట్ దట్ ఈస్ రాంగ్. ద పీరియడ్ యూజువలీ షుడ్ బీ బిట్వీన్ 21-35 డేస్. ఈవెన్ బిట్వీన్ 21-35 డేస్ ఈజ్ నార్మల్ మెన్స్ట్రల్ సైకిల్. సో వాట్ హ్యాపన్స్ ఇన్ పీసీఓఎస్ ఇస్ విమెన్ డోంట్ గెట్ పీరియడ్స్ అప్ టిల్ 2-3 మంత్స్ ఆఫ్ డ్యూరేషన్, ఆర్ సమ్టైమ్స్ దే డోంట్ గెట్ పీరియడ్స్ అట్ ఆల్ అంటిల్ దే టేక్ సమ్ మెడికేషన్. సో దాట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ మెన్స్ట్రల్ ఇర్రెగ్యులారిటీ విచ్ వీ సీ ఇన్ పీసీఓఎస్ విమెన్. సో దట్ ఈస్ వన్ ఆఫ్ ద మోస్ట్ కామన్. ఆల్మోస్ట్ 3/4 పేషెంట్ విల్ ప్రెజెంట్ విత్ మెన్స్ట్రల్ ఇర్రెగ్యులారిటీస్. ద సెకండ్ మోస్ట్ కామన్ వాట్ ఐ సీ ఇస్ ఎక్సెసివ్ హెయిర్ గ్రోత్. బేసికలీ వాట్ హ్యాపన్స్ ఇస్ దిస్ ఎక్సెసివ్ ఆండ్రోజన్ లెవెల్స్ ఇన్ పీసీఓఎస్. అంటే ఆల్ ఉమెన్ విల్ హ్యావ్ సమ్ మేల్ హార్మోన్ ఇన్ దర్ బాడీ, బట్ దట్ ఈస్ ఇన్ వెరీ స్మాల్ లెవెల్. దట్ ఈస్ అ సీరమ్ టెస్టోస్టెరాన్ విచ్ దే హ్యావ్. బట్ వాట్ హ్యాపన్స్ ఇన్ పీసీఓఎస్ ఇస్ దెర్ ఇస్ ఇంక్రీజ్ ఇన్ దిస్ సీరమ్ టెస్టోస్టెరాన్ విచ్ ఇస్ ప్రెజెంట్ ఇన్ ద బాడీ. సో వెన్ దెర్ ఇస్ ఇంక్రీజ్ ఇన్ సీరమ్ టెస్టోస్టెరాన్, ద ఆండ్రోజన్ లెవెల్స్ ఆర్ increase, so that will cause more of excessive unwanted hair growth, especially on the upper lips, chin, sideburns, on the chest and the back. And one more symptom which patients with excessive androgen levels I see is because of the excess oil production, there's excess acne which I see on the face. Acne in simple words is called as pimples. So those pimples are so prominent that it becomes red and excessive all over the face, sometimes on the neck, sometimes on the back, and that leads the patients to come for us. And the third most common symptom which I see patients coming with is excessive weight gain, that is obesity, and bloating sensation in the lower abdomen. And most of the married women who come to me come with complaints of inability to become pregnant or conceive, that is called as infertility. And the fifth most common also a syndrome which is associated with PCOS is called as acanthosis nigrans. And this acanthosis nigrans means dark blackish brown discoloration which is seen on the face, the neck, the groin region, the axilla and most of the skin folds. And this acanthosis nigrans is because of the insulin resistance which takes place in PCOS. Now I would like to explain one very important thing here, that is about the weight gain and its relation, that is obesity and its relation to PCOS. What happens when there is PCOS? There is insulin sensitivity. That is, insulin sensitivity is reduced, which causes insulin resistance. When there is insulin resistance, there is excessive fat deposition in the body. When there is excessive fat deposition in the body, there is excessive fat cells, which in turn makes a woman harder to lose weight. That is, there is excessive weight gain. Now, because of this fat cell deposition, there is some estrogen which is secreted in the blood, which actually causes increase in the hormonal imbalance, and this causes more of PCOS. So basically, PCOS will lead to weight gain, and weight gain again will cause PCOS. So this is a vicious cycle which keeps on happening. So the challenge for us when it comes to PCOS is breaking this vicious cycle. So it's very difficult to break this vicious cycle. Once we attain that stage where we can break this vicious cycle, it's very easy for us to treat PCOS. So basically, these are the 5-6 symptoms which the patients come to us with when they're having PCOS.
Okay ma'am, PCOS ni ela diagnose chestaru asalu?
Okay, there are 3 criteria to diagnose PCOS. The first criteria, as I've already explained to you, is the irregular periods, that is the menstrual irregularities which the patient will have. The second criteria is androgen excess. Androgen excess is the excess of hair which is present on the upper lips, chin, face, etc., as well as acne. And the third criteria and the most important criteria is the pelvic ultrasonography. Pelvic ultrasonography tells polycystic ovaries are there or not. So in PCOS, usually a pelvic ultrasonography shows polycystic ovaries. What is polycystic ovaries? They are fluid filled cysts which are present around the periphery of the ovary. And this is usually seen as a string of pearl appearance on ultrasound, and that is called as polycystic ovary. So these are the three criteria where we diagnose PCOS. And a woman can present with any of the two diagnostic criteria, then it is certain that she is suffering from PCOS. So mainly these three diagnostic criteria are used to diagnose PCOS.
Okay ma'am, alage investigations enti PCOS ki?
Yeah, basically I would divide investigations into two things. One is a radiological investigation, another one is the blood tests which we do. And definitely the radiological investigation is the most important test I would suggest. That is a pelvic ultrasound. And in pelvic ultrasound, we see for polycystic ovaries picture. And also sometimes the ovarian volume, that is the ovaries itself will look big. That is bulky ovaries, which is seen on ultrasound. And the second thing is the blood tests. And in the blood tests, the first is the hormonal assays which we do. It is usually done on day two of the cycle. We do the following hormones, that is the follicle stimulating hormone, it is called as FSH, and the luteinizing hormone, that is called LH, the prolactin levels, and then the thyroid profile. So these two are the basic PCOD investigations which has to be done for all the patients who come with the symptoms of PCOS. The other special investigation depends on the patient's presentation. Like if a patient comes with insulin resistance, what insulin resistance is, when our body resists to act for the natural insulin to act. That is, the natural insulin is not able to break the blood glucose in the body. This causes increase in weight gain and increased blood sugar. So basically when patients come with increased weight gain, that is all obese patients and whose blood sugars are high, you have to do a fasting blood sugars for them, as well as a serum fasting insulin levels, which is more accurate in telling us the insulin resistance. And some patients who come with excessive hair growth or acne vulgaris, in such patients we would like to see the androgen levels in the body, and the tests which we do are serum testosterone or serum THEA levels. But in all this, the most diagnostic of PCOS is the luteinizing hormone and the FSH levels, which I said. The luteinizing hormones is mostly double, triple or quadruple times more than the follicle stimulating hormone in PCOS women. That ratio of LH to FSH is drastically increased in PCOS, and it is the diagnostic test for us to say that a woman is suffering from PCOS.
ఓకే మ్యామ్, ఈ పీసీఓఎస్ అనేది ఏ ఏజ్ గ్రూప్ వాళ్ళకి ఎక్కువగా వచ్చే ఛాన్సెస్ ఉన్నాయంటారు?
మోస్ట్లీ దట్స్ వాట్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ పీసీఓఎస్ ఇస్ ప్రెజెంట్ ఇన్ రీప్రొడక్టివ్ ఏజ్ గ్రూప్, దట్ ఈస్ బిట్వీన్ 88 to 44 ఇయర్స్ ఆఫ్ ఏజ్. ఈవెన్ అ యంగ్ గర్ల్, ఓన్లీ థింగ్ ఇస్ ద ప్రెజెంటేషన్ వేరీస్. అ యంగ్ గర్ల్ యాజ్ వెల్ యాజ్ అ 40 ఇయర్ ఓల్డ్ ఉమెన్, బోత్ ఆఫ్ దెమ్ కెన్ సఫర్ ఫ్రమ్ పీసీఓఎస్. బట్ అ యంగ్ గర్ల్ విల్ సఫర్ మోర్ బికాస్ ఆఫ్ వెయిట్ గెయిన్, because of irregular cycles, abnormal menses. But an older woman might suffer due to complications associated with PCOS, like infertility or diabetes, hypertension or cardiovascular diseases. So it is prevalent almost in the entire reproductive age group. So it's not like only young girls can get PCOS, the older women cannot. That concept is wrong, that only young girls will get PCOS. It is present almost throughout the reproductive age group.
Okay ma'am, ee PCOS ki complications enti ee problem unna vallaki?
See, there are short-term complications which I have explained to you, the menstrual irregularities, acne, excessive unwanted facial hair growth, and all those things are the short-term effects. The most important and the dreadful complications are the long-term complications of PCOS, which none of the women see. That's why there is not much awareness in India about PCOS. The most common long-term complications which we see is infertility. Usually patients come to us very late, after a few years of not able to conceive, they come to us with infertility complaints, with PCOS. And the second is metabolic syndrome. The metabolic syndrome comprises of diabetes, hypertension and cardiovascular diseases. So most of the women with PCOS celebrate their 40th birthday with diabetes, hypertension and cardiovascular diseases. So it's definitely a long-term complication of PCOS, and it is very difficult to treat metabolic syndrome as such. So it is very important that we don't let women reach the metabolic syndrome and treat at an early age. And one more dreadful complication which I have seen with PCOS is the uterine cancers, that is the endometrial cancers. Usually what happens is PCOS, there will be anovulation. That is because of menstrual irregularities, patients don't get their periods. That is because there is no ovulation, that is called anovulation, which happens in PCOS. Because of this anovulation, what happens is your endometrial lining is thickened. When the endometrial lining is thickened for over ages, about 20 years, when you neglect that and when you come after 20 years, that leads to endometrial hyperplasia and endometrial cancers or the uterine cancers. So these are the long-term complications which has to be avoided. So there should be some awareness about PCOS in all women so that they come at an early time and avoid all these long-term complications.
ఓకే మ్యామ్, ఈ పీసీఓఎస్ ప్రాబ్లం ఉన్న వాళ్ళు ఎలాంటి జాగ్రత్తలు తీసుకోవాలి, ఫుడ్ ఎలాంటి తీసుకోవాలి, అలాగే ఎక్సర్సైజెస్ ఏమైనా చేయాలా, ఎలాంటి తీసుకోవాలి?
సో బేసికలీ కమింగ్ టు లైక్ ట్రీట్మెంట్ ఆఫ్ పీసీఓఎస్ యు ఆర్ టెలింగ్, సీ బిఫోర్ టెలింగ్ ద ట్రీట్మెంట్ ఆఫ్ పీసీఓఎస్, లెట్ మీ టెల్ యూ టైప్స్ ఆఫ్ పీసీఓఎస్. యూ హ్యావ్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్ టైప్స్ ఆఫ్ పీసీఓఎస్, దెన్ యూల్ అండర్స్టాండ్ విచ్ టైప్, విచ్ పర్టిక్యులర్ ట్రీట్మెంట్ వీ కెన్ గివ్. దెర్ ఆర్ యూజువలీ 4 టైప్స్ ఆఫ్ పీసీఓఎస్. ద ఫస్ట్ వన్ ఇస్ ద insulin resistant PCOS, which causes your increase in weight gain and irregular menses and infertility with increased blood sugar levels. The second type is your adrenal PCOS. In the adrenal PCOS, usually what happens is there will be increase in androgen levels, which leads to increase in serum testosterone and serum DHAs, which leads to excessive hair growth and acne. The third one is the post pill PCOS, which is caused due to long-term intake of hormonal pills. The fourth and the most important is the inflammatory PCOS. And most of the PCOS, about 70% of what I see, is inflammatory PCOS. This inflammatory PCOS is purely due to stress, dietary changes, and lifestyle modifications. So these are the causes for inflammatory PCOS. So as I already told you that all patients who come to me, each patient is different for me. Like each patient have different complaints, different presentations, and the treatment also for each patient is different. And as it is, PCOS treatment is a debatable topic. So every person, every patient or every woman, treatment is individualized with PCOS. First, let me give an example of a young woman who comes to me. A young woman, maybe around 18 years or 20 years, like that. She's come with complaints of irregular menses and a little bit of weight gain. And so, clinically, diagnostic two criteria she meets. So, I diagnose her as PCOS. But the main thing when I diagnose, the next step what I do is some investigations to confirm that she's having PCOS. When I do blood tests, if there is any derangement in thyroid and prolactin levels, then it's very easy. You can give some medications or oral supplementations to combat that problem. But when it comes to pure PCOS or the inflammatory type of PCOS, That is where the problem lies, because the most cause for that will be your stress, lifestyle changes, and your dietary changes. So your treatment also should be similarly in changing the stress levels, dietary changes, and the lifestyle modifications. So the treatment of pure or inflammatory PCOS, PCOS, what I suggest is lifestyle modification. The first line of management we follow in PCOS is definitely lifestyle modification and dietary changes. First of all, you should find out the triggering factor for PCOS. If it is anything related to lifestyle, dietary, and stress, we have to do things to change the following. First thing is you have to reduce the psychological and mental stress. There are different ways you can do. The most important and a very common and a very nice one method what I advise to most of my patients is yoga and meditation. It does wonders in reducing stress, and it's a very good form of relaxation for most of them who have psychological stress induced PCOS, or any other form like listening to relaxing music or whatever relaxing hobbies they have. Any of it you can do and reduce your stress levels and psychological stress in you. The second most important thing what I tell my patients is to have good sleep. Good sleep, I mean about at least 8 hours of sleep, and 8 hours of night sleep, I don't mean sleeping at 3 a.m. and getting up at 11 a.m. That is also a cause for increasing your stress. That night sleep is very important because there are some hormone called melatonin which reduces the stress in the body when you sleep for 8 hours during the night time, that is between 10 a.m. to 6 a.m. specifically. So these two things are very, very important, that is to reduce your stress levels and also good sleep which you have, and a regular sleep pattern is also very important. So this is the first lifestyle modification I would advise for patients with PCOS. The second is the dietary changes, which is the most important at present time, because I think most of us feel like going out and eating bakery food, deep fried food, pastries, pizzas, burgers, so many things. My advice would be, first thing is change of diet. So what I advise my patients is to reduce the sugars, the white sugar or the processed sugar. The foods which have processed sugar is all this what I told, like, you know, your processed food, preserved foods, your bakery items, junk, all those things. It's combined together called as junk food. So the first thing I try to tell them is avoid junk food, and to take complex carbohydrates. What is complex carbohydrates means? To take ragi, johar, and brown rice, millets, oats, instead of your all this, instead of all the junk and the white rice which you use. What is the advantage when you use complex carbohydrates is, the digestion is less with it. The absorption levels are reduced. So when the digestion and absorption levels are reduced, it stays in your stomach for a longer time. So when it stays in your stomach for a longer time, your binge eating is reduced when you take such complex carbohydrates. And also what I would advise is a high protein diet and a high fiber diet. I would suggest all of them to take minimum of 2 to 3 liters of water, and also increase your fruits and vegetable levels in your food. These are all the things which increase the fiber in your diet. Okay. So mainly to reduce the white sugar or the processed sugar, what I call, that is the junk, should be totally reduced and have a healthier diet life. I really don't recommend on crash diet or a fat diet, which most of them do. Because the main aim in PCOS is not to lose weight and become thin. The main aim is to have a healthy lifestyle change. And when you have this healthy lifestyle change, about 60% of patients with healthy lifestyle change actually see spontaneous ovulation, spontaneous menstruation within next 3 to 6 months.
Okay.
Isn't that really wonderful? Like no medication, absolutely nothing, just pure diet and, you know, exercise. All this causes, you know, your treatment is with this.
Okay.
So it's a very good thing to have healthy diet.
Okay.
And the third lifestyle change is what I would suggest is some form of exercise. It can be either walking for 30 minutes or slow pace exercises or any form of yoga or Surya Namaskaras, whatever comes in yoga. So any of these things you can do for 30 minutes a day also is really helpful for treating PCOS. So basically, all these lifestyle modifications help a lot in treating PCOS.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. PCOS, Kurin Chepanandku, thank you so much. Idi Valti Good Health, keep watching Basics News.